What's up, everybody? Afro Joe here, coming to you from where I'm at. But today I want to talk about this damn girl. Her name is like Valencia Nathan, and I feel like this. Like, I don't know what it is about this girl. She's 16 years old. 16 years old, and she's dating a 25-year-old named David. Dave. Now, you're probably sitting up there, it's like, okay, where's the parents? The father is very fucking furious. The mother, she don't know what to do. But on the show, man, I sat there and I watched the show, and I sat there and I was more pissed than the motherfucker because what I saw. The boyfriend, Dave, has been sitting up there giving this girl pills. Getting her high, getting her drunk. She's 16 years old. You probably wonder, where they doing it at? I think up in Pennsylvania. But it was on the Dr.Phil show Tuesday. And I sat here, and I was more pissed than a motherfucker. I was like, why is a 25-year-old dating a 16-year-old? I was like, where's the parents in all this? The parents, the mother, she's pissed. The father looks like he's ready to kill. It already got to a point where the father, like, I feel so bad for the father because he did one thing wrong. He actually put his hands on his daughter, because that's how pissed he was, trying to keep her away from him. I know that is wrong, to be beating on your children like that. He choked her, smacked her, and all this and that. But it's still wrong to do that to a child. And that's what he admitted, that he did the wrong thing. And he has every right as a fucking parent to be pissed off at him. And it makes me fucking think the shit that he says. Oh, I'm gonna get your daughter pregnant so you can kiss my ass. She's 16 years old. He says things like, oh, I can't wait for 2 years so I can marry her. Where the state they live in, he can date a minor, but he can't marry her. I'm scratching my motherfucking head. I'm pondering. I'm wondering about the government. Oh, what the government got to do? The government makes these laws. You know, the little rules they make. Oh, you can't kill nobody unless you want to be killed. And I sit up there and I was questioning this. I say, okay, I'm kind of... You make these laws to protect the child. Instead of the laws protecting the child, you let the damn states make these fucked up laws to let him fuck any damn minor he wants. Where I'm from, he would have been locked up getting his ass poked out in prison right about now. He would have been locked up, he would have been on parole for beating on his child for child abuse. But still, he would have been on probation for child abuse, but he would have got his ass poked out for fucking the damn minor. And I still look at us like, why do you let this shit happen in this world? Why do you make these laws to protect a fucking pedophile? He's a fucking pedophile. Dr. Phil even called him pedophile. I sat there and did videos about fucking kids getting fucked in school. And what happened? Getting fucked in school, getting fucked in homes, getting fucked in the street, getting fucked in churches. And still, these damn states don't wake up. You ever wonder, it's like, for real, you make these laws, but you break them. How can you make a law and then break the law? I think in Alabama, I don't know, somebody correct me on this one if you watch this video. Correct me if I'm wrong. Ain't in Alabama or Albuquerque or something like that, I know it's the southern state where... A child, somebody that's under the age of 18 can marry somebody over the age of 21, but only if the parents consent. Only if a parent is consent. Now, I look at that, I was like, okay, only if a parent consent. I'm scratching my head and I'm pondering. I was like, only if parents consent. And it still goes against the whole it's only the state laws. It's not the government laws that's doing it. The government says you can't rape a child if you want to go to fucking prison and get killed. But state laws, oh, you can rape a child all you fucking want, but you can't marry them in several states, but you can marry them in some states. And I sit up here and I'm questioning this shit because one thing is about it that I'm questioning is about, it's like you letting guys like him get away with child molestation. And that's one thing. You letting this guys like him get away with child molestation, rape, and he's giving drugs to minors, and he's still walking the streets fucking this girl. And I'm questioning this shit because they don't do nothing about it. They don't do shit about it. But when it comes down to it, how come only it's always the northern states that actually fucks up more than the southern states on the child laws. But everybody knows the Trayvon Martin case, but that was a fuck up. That was a fuck up. Didn't know that whole. But let's forget about Trayvon Martin. But I'm saying this like this. I'm saying it like this, that you make the government makes these laws. The government makes these laws. The laws are not meant to be broken. And when you make these laws protecting the child, it never works. It never works because one thing is, the way I see it is, that I'd rather make a law that protects every child out there. It doesn't matter how old the child is. The child is under the age of 18. Why is this child getting raped? It doesn't matter what state the child is in. Only thing it should matter is that the child should be protected. But it seems like the childs are not getting protected because you allow fuckers like these rock the streets from raping kids. What was that? Teddy Long got caught raping several kids. What happened? He's still walking the fucking streets. And that's how it is. He's still walking the streets. Now, I question that. He's still walking straight, and I'm sitting up there scratching my head, wondering what's going on. I'm sitting up here. I was like, why do cases like this got to end up on Dr.Phil, Oprah, so on and so forth, on those kind of media, but these people get to walk the streets and they never get punished. They never get fucking punished. And I'm sitting up there angry as fuck because these state laws allow this to happen. And that's one thing I don't get, is these state laws allowing this to happen and they don't do a damn thing about it. And it's just I sit up here pissed as hell. Every day I sit here and I question this. Why do these people get away with raping and molesting and all this to kids? And they go up on the Dr. Phil show, or they go up on Oprah, or they go up on Katie Curry, or they go up on Dr. Oz, or they go up on Dr. Drew. All these shows in the media. I say, if they going on the show, how could... Look, it's like this. To me, it's like this. It's like this. If I was in these hosts' shoes, and I had some guy that's having sex with the minors, this is what I would do. 1, do the interview. 2, at the show ends, call the cops and have and press charges. 3, see if the parents want to press charges too. Because one thing is, it's bullshit how this is going down. And they're allowing this to happen. Because one thing is, if this was my child, if she was my child, he'd be dead already. He'd be dead already. I don't give a fuck. He's 25. I did a video about a fucking college professor that left his wife to date a girl his daughter's age. I did a video about a teacher feeding his students his semen, and he's doing time. I did a video about a girl getting molested by her own father and having 3 kids from her own father, but only 1 survived and 2 died. The girl's father is doing life in prison. I have did videos constantly about pedophiles going to prison. Oh, but it's okay for a northern state to make up bullshit laws that allows this man to fuck any young girl he wants and get away with it? How come? Why is this happening in this country? Why is it happening in this country? Why? That is the main question. Why is this country going to shit? The child laws are bullshit because they never back them up. But it's okay to back up the murder laws, the theft laws, the drug laws. It's okay to back those laws, those kind of laws up. But when it comes down to a child law, they don't back it up. They don't do nothing about it. So when the government says children are our future, how can children be our future when you allowed them to get killed? When you allowed them to get molested, when you allowed them to get raped, when you allowed them to get hurt, when you allowed them to die, because they don't give a shit. Because if I was in government, I would have forced the laws bad as a motherfucker. I would have seen guys like this sitting in the jail cell, and I would have snitched his ass out, pedophile on cell block D, motherfuckers. Doesn't matter if you're black, white, Hispanic, gay, straight, male or female, transgender, what the fuck? If you molesting kids, why are you walking the streets? Why are you walking the streets, man? Even some murderers don't even get to walk the streets. But this guy gets to rape the kids and walk the streets? And this is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about. This is bullshit. It pisses me off to the core, man, to see this man walk the streets having sex with this girl and getting her high and drunk. But it seems like people don't give a fuck. It seems like parents, like, I give props to the father because what the fuck he did, he is so pissed. I give him props. Because I seen the anger in his fucking eyes and the anger on his face. He's so much anger and so much hate, man, that I thought you could see the anger. His face got so red that I thought his head would blow the fuck up. But that's how it is, man. That's how it is. That this happens every day and nobody does nothing about it. Kids getting molested in the streets. What happens? Nothing. And I think it's bullshit. And that's all I got to say on this, man. Tell me what you think about this situation. Follow me on Twitter at AfroJoeTheWookie. Follow me on Tumblr. Subscribe to my channel, CeeLo Jr. 2, CeeLo Jr. 3, and tell me what you think. I'm Afro Joe. Tell like a T.I. is. Peace, love, and Afro.